Thank you, Ariane and the panel. I actually just wanted to say that there's not going to be any concluding remarks or wrap up of the session. It's been a magnificent statement in some of the essentials of the Beijing platform, in effect, with regards to violence, has been reiterated and expanded in a very thoughtful manner. And we have had strategies, largely, that we have learned since Beijing, how to, in effect, expand our reach, how to reach across disciplines, across genders, across various lines of nationality and region, religion and culture, etc., so that we can mobilize and we can move together and get to our particular goals. And I think the most important thing that we can come away with in terms of a 2020 vision for 10 years from now is the fact that we have to contextualize not only violence, but the issue of equality within power structures. The power to create knowledge, the power to communicate, the power to make decisions, the power to be present where decisions are made to influence them. And that power comes from consciousness, it comes from awareness, it comes from determination to do something and the belief that we can, and it comes from strengthening that feeling in each other and across borders. And the various campaigns really, I think, very nicely discussed how that can be done. And in the very nice spirit of both diversity and solidarity between East and West, and culture and literature, and including men, I would like to take the privilege of a Persian and Iranian and quote a poem. I'm going to quote the poem from our Persian poet Saadi, who's a man. And I'm going to say it in Persian, and there are a few of you here who will follow it, but then I will do the English. In Persian, Saadi says, بنی آدم اعضای یکدیگرند که در آفرینش ز یک گوهرند که چو عضوی به درد آورد روزگار دیگر عضوها را نماند قرار. Now, in order to translate it, I can't actually translate that sentiment. It's a sentiment that has been repeated a lot here, but I'll use another man, this time a Western man, who has the same idea. John Donne, he said, no man is an island entire unto himself. Any man's death diminishes me, for I am involved in mankind. So I think this is the sentiment that has been repeated here. Men, women, Muslims, Christians, various cultures, and I think Parveen was the last one to say it, if one person, one woman, one man, one child is hurt in one part of the world, the rest of mankind is hurt as well. So if we're going to get there in 2020, we got to do it together. And I think that that's the sentiment that we can take away together from this day. So I want to, before I end, I want to really thank all of you who have been so patient and so good to be with us all day. I also want to thank, first and foremost, our partners, the New School for Social Research and the Social Research Journal, and especially Arian Mack and Roberta Sutton, who have been so good in organizing, and, of course, the volunteers. And more than anything, I appreciate, really, the presence of both the keynote speakers and other major speakers, because it's been such a horrendously busy 2 weeks, and they have made sure that they would be here at any price. And I really thank all of them, Melanne Verveer, Mary Robinson, Shirin Ebadi, and Thoraya Obaid, as well as Asma Khadar, Jacqueline Pitenge, Lina Abu Habib, Amal Abdul Hadi, Cindy Meadow Gold, and Parveen Ardalan. And they have been wonderful and very inspiring. And I want to thank our team from WLP, Rocky, Usha, Jennifer, Siobhan, Tyler, And the wonderful volunteer we had, Marae, and the people who've been taping this, the Rain Lake productions, and Deb, our producer, who's going to make, we're going to be making a wonderful 20-minute documentary on violence against women. So thank you all. Wonderful audience, wonderful speakers, wonderful organizers. I appreciate it. Thank you.